It's an honor to speak to you today, particularly in celebration of the 30th anniversary of the internet in Korea, because this country, as much as any on the planet, has been a leader in bringing the online world to its citizens. If one has to sum up Korea's approach to the internet in one short phrase, it would be fastest in the world. And if one has to sum up your approach to the future of the internet in only one single word, it would, of course, be faster. Your efforts to bring average internet speeds to 1 gigabit per second by the end of 2012 are gaining international attention. I hope that you took pride when President Obama pointed to Korea several months ago while unveiling an $18 billion broadband spending program in the U.S. He made it clear that the United States should follow the Korean approach to dramatically increasing internet speeds. In other words, you are leading the world. Your bandwidth will accommodate technologies that have not yet entered the marketplace, such as high-definition multimedia and ultra-high-definition TV. There is general agreement among technologists that gigabit speeds will help define the online future, a future for which Korea is well prepared. That future is all the more impressive when you consider that the system development network started 30 years ago with only 1,200 bits per second of bandwidth. But it is not simply your broadband speeds that are impressive. It is also Korea's desire to make those speeds widely accessible. The fact that 83% of your population, more than 40 million people, can access the internet speaks to your understanding that it is a vital tool for all and should not be considered a luxury only for the affluent. It's to your credit that you're throwing open to all the fast lanes of the information superhighway. I stand in awe that a customer in one of the 1,500 households taking part in the Korean pilot gigabit project pays only about 30,000 won a month. It's breathtaking to see how quickly Koreans have embraced the internet. I have reviewed many statistics about online growth in your country, but one in particular sticks out because it shows in very non-technical terms how quickly the internet has been adopted. The first internet cafe opened in Korea in September 1995, and 4 years later, there were more than 15,000. That's enormous growth. That is not only a lot of internet connections, of course, it is also a lot of coffee. Perhaps that explains your amazing internet infrastructure development, since it appears that with all that coffee you're drinking, nobody's getting much sleep. It's not just the internet infrastructure that's changing. The domain name system is also going through an evolutionary transformation. 2 years ago, you kindly hosted the ICANN meeting in Seoul. That meeting ended with the approval of a fast-track system for internationalized domain names to be used for country code top-level domains. It means that ccTLD scripts did not have to be in Latin characters. For the first time since the .kr country code appeared in 1986, it could now be written in a web browser's address space in Hangul. But opening up the country code top-level space to non-Latin scripts was only the beginning. As you're well aware, ICANN has been taking applications for new generic top-level domains. This means the use of non-Latin-based scripts will expand even more broadly. It means that within a few years, gTLDs in Hangul, Arabic, Cyrillic, and other non-Latin languages will begin to spring up in yet another historic change to the domain name system. What that really means is that the internet will become more accessible, not only by an expanding infrastructure, but also by nature of an expanding and evolving address system. You can build the fastest online system in the world, but if the address system doesn't easily take you where you want to go, then you have a wonderful high-speed highway with a wholly inadequate system of signs and exits. Speed matters, but only if you can reach your destination. ICANN is largely a technical organization whose mission is, in part, to support the use of internet standards and protocols. But that's the formal definition. Quite simply, one of our primary functions is to help assure that billions of internet users can safely and securely reach their online destinations. We are an organization like very few. We define ourselves by the inclusivity of all our voices. Governments, businesses, and even unaffiliated internet users give us input in what we call our multi-stakeholder model. Those of you who have attended ICANN meetings know that we are an organization which is often defined by discussion, debate, and, yes, even dissent. But that is okay. we do not fear any of those voices. We spend far more time worrying about the voices which are unheard. Unlike Korea's internet infrastructure, we are not very fast, but then we do go out of our way not to be. Take our generic top-level domain as an example. It was the result of 6 years of thoughtful discussion, debate, and study. Some 60 technical papers and independent reports were written, along with the analysis of 2,400 comments. The applicant guidebook went through 7 drafts, with each version being put up for public comment. Yet we still have critics who say we have moved too fast. And our response to them is to invite them into our community, to attend our meetings, and to engage with others from around the world who will help us define an online future. We believe that all stakeholders, regardless of whether they are from government, business, or any other sector, should be heard. In support of our position, take a look at the internet as we know it today, arguably one of the greatest inventions of mankind, one that has redefined global commerce, communication, education, and entertainment. But even more exciting is the internet of the future, not the one we can foresee, but the one that we cannot begin to imagine. Thank you, and allow me to again to congratulate you on your 30-year anniversary of the internet in Korea.